In this problem, we're told an Olympic class sprinter starts a race with an acceleration of 4.5 meters per second squared. A, what is her position 2.4 seconds later? And B, sketch a graph of her position versus time for this period. So the first thing you always want to do is draw what's going on. So we have this sprinter, right? And we know at the beginning of the race, they're starting, right? So they're going to start at rest, but they're going to accelerate at 4.5 meters per second squared, right? And then they're going to travel for 2.4 seconds. And we're trying to find their velocity at this point right here. So what you want to do next is write down the given for this interval of the kinematic variables. So we're given the initial velocity, right? They start at rest, so we know the initial velocity is 0 meters per second. We know that the time it's going to take, right? 2.4 seconds. We're given the acceleration, right? 4.5 meters per second squared. And what we're trying to do is solve for v, the final velocity, right? And so what we want to do now is, since we have three kinematic variables, what we can do is plug them into one of the kinematic equations right here, and we're going to be able to solve for what we want to find, right? We're trying to find v. So the equation we're going to use, right, is the first equation. And the reason we're using that one is, notice 2 through 4 all contain delta x, which we don't have. And if you look at the equation, right, the top one, v equals v sub 0 plus a times t, notice we have v sub 0, we have a, and we have t. So what we can do is solve for the final velocity. So all we have to do is just plug it in. So v equals v sub 0. V sub 0 is 0, so 0 plus anything is just this. So it's the acceleration, which is 4.5 times 2.4. So do 4.5 times 2.4, you're going to get V equals 10.8. And so the units for this, right, we measure velocity in meters per second. So it's going to be 10.8 meters per second. So this is going to be the velocity after 2.4 seconds. So this is your answer to A. And so now for B, what they want us to do is sketch a graph of her position, right, versus time. So I'm just going to give a rough estimate. So, right, we have time on the bottom, and then this is the position. So let's think about this, right? She's going to be accelerating, meaning the speed she's going to be going at, or this, the amount she's gaining each second, is going to be increasing, right? Because she's going to travel faster and faster and faster and faster and faster. So if we do position, right, this is going to go up way faster than the time, right? The time is just linear, right? But it's going to be an exponential graph like this, right? This is just a rough estimate. But it's going to be exponential like this, right? Because her position is going to get greater each second that passes because we have an acceleration, right? Hopefully that makes sense, but this is a rough estimate. So yeah, this is going to be your answer to B, and then this was your answer to A, and yeah, hopefully you found this useful.